A good application for Galvalume really would be...
I'm Thad Barnett from Sheffield Metals, and I'm very excited to introduce the first ever Q&A Monday here on the Metal Roofing Channel. Every Monday, we will be answering questions about everything metal roofing. If you have a question, comment below to have your question answered in future episodes. Today, I have Mike Blake and Adam Mazzella with me from Sheffield Metals. How are you guys doing?
Great.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, no problem. So tell me a little bit first about yourselves and your experience in the industry.
Go ahead, Mike.
I started in October of 2003 and started off as president. And I had a background in the steel industry and got a new opportunity to come get involved in the painted business, which I did.
Okay. I started April 2008 and started in sales and kind of just worked my way up. Now vice president of sales and marketing.
Awesome. So today the conversation will be revolving mostly around Galvalume. And we've got a couple questions here. I'm going to start us off. What is the difference between Galvalume and galvanized? They sound kind of similar, but what's the difference?
Well, you know, galvanized is a coating and galvalume's a coating. Galvanized is basically zinc, and galvalume is a combination of aluminum and zinc. And so, you know, the problem with steel, it rusts unless you coat it. So there's really two ways to prevent rust. One is a barrier, and the other is a galvanic protection. And so if you would coat a steel with just galvanized, it does a moderate job at the barrier protection, but it does an excellent job in galvanic. On the other hand, if you coat it with aluminum, it does an excellent job on the barrier, but does a poor job on galvanic. So therefore, they created what's called Galvalume today. Back in the 70s, and it's really 55% aluminum and, you know, 43.5% zinc, which gave the best of both worlds. And, you know, basically the corrosive resistance of Galvalume is about 2 to 4 times better than it is galvanized.
So related to Galvalume, another question is, what kind of special considerations do you need when installing Galvalume, handling Galvalume? Is there anything that you need to keep in mind?
Yeah, there's a couple real important ones. Animal confinement is a problem because the manure breaks down into ammonia gas, and then it reacts with the coating, and it beats the coating up pretty bad. Or coastal environment, in which, you know, you get a situation with a lot of salt, then you get sodium chloride, and then again, it has a bad effect on the coating.
So other than those kind of considerations on where to install, what type of building it is, when is Galvalume a good choice for roofing?
Galvalume's usually a good roofing choice, really, when you're not on the coast or when you're in a, agriculture environment that has animals involved in it. Otherwise, it's great for residential, it's great for industrial, commercial, you name it.
So other than the two things that Mike said that it wasn't good use for, it was, you know, it's good for everything else pretty
much. Yeah, and I would say that's a big thing. You know, other applications where it comes up, you kind of look at, you know, oil canning and things like that. Galvanized has better characteristics when it comes to oil canning than Galvalume. But is that trade-off in, you know, the potential for oil canning enough to offset, you know, going with a product that's warranted in Galvalume versus a product that's unwarranted in galvanized? And that's really up to the building owner.
You see, is Galvalume extremely popular as far as all metal roofing types?
Yeah, I would say since the late 90s, early 2000s, 90%+ of the industry has really transitioned from galvanized substrate to a Galvalume substrate. Like Mike said, there certainly is a place and there is a home for galvanized in the industry. But by and large, end users want a product that's warranted. You know, and then you can do things, you know, to minimize oil canning, such as tension leveling, equalizing a deck, making sure it's in plane, things like that, or adding structure to panels, you name it, whole laundry list.
Was there a cost difference between galvanized and Galvalume?
Historically, galvanized was generally cheaper, but I guess over the last, probably since 2004, it's kind of fluctuated back and forth, and they're generally pretty close to each other in terms of cost.
So it seems like the main consideration is what type of building is it used on, where is your building located, to really make that decision.
Yeah, and at that, if you're by a coast, you're not going to use galvanized or Galvalume. I mean, generally, you're going to use aluminum or a stainless or a copper or a zinc, something of that nature.
So, Adam, tell me about some similarities between galvanized and Galvalume.
Yeah, so, you know, obviously we're going to sit here and tout Galvalume, not just because most of the industry has switched over or we're almost exclusively Galvalume, but there's a warranty on Galvalume. You know, all steel-based products are going to have some degree of edge creep. You know, there's ways to offset that, whether it's hemming exposed edges or touching up exposed edges with paint pens to make it last a little bit longer. But Galvalume has self-healing characteristics where, kind of right out of the gate, it might have a little bit more edge creep than a galvanized roof might have. It's not going to have that red rust and then continue to red rust. When galvanized starts to red rust, it kind of just starts to go, and it goes rather quickly. Where Galvalume, like we said, has the self-healing properties, and it, you'll get some degree, and then it'll kind of stop, and you should be good.
And that's the big reason why it's warrantable, right?
Yes. Yeah, it's warrantable because the self-healing characteristics, as well as its proven track record.
So, Mike, how long do you think a galvanized roof will last compared to a Galvalume roof?
Well, of course, a galvanized roof in the right environment can last a long time as well. But Galvalume roofs have been around a long time, and there's been studies done that by the MCA that have proven that metal roofs of Galvalume have lasted well over 60 years.
And we will link those in the description for you if you want to check those studies out. All right, so today we learned the difference between Galvalume and galvanized, as well as some special considerations needed for installation, where to install, different buildings. Thanks for joining me, Adam and Mike. I definitely learned a lot. Definitely subscribe to the Metal Roofing Channel presented by Sheffield Metals. Comment below for any questions, anything else. Check out Sheffield Metals online, and I'll catch you next time.